You've heard the phrase, an apple doesn't fall far from the tree, meaning you're a reflection of your parents and your children are a reflection of you. But it goes much deeper than that, to genetics and the role they play in your health. This morning, we're examining how simple lab tests can help improve our health. Returning to the show once again is Dr. Jay Wohlgemuth of Quest Diagnostics Incorporated. Good morning. Welcome back.
Thanks, Olga. So glad to be back.
All right. So the last time we got together, we talked about the importance of blood work and our health. They both go hand in hand.
Absolutely. In summary, really, it's about proactive healthcare, knowing what's going on before it becomes a major problem so you can intervene and get better or prevent problems from occurring in the future.
So today, let's take it a step further, Dr. Jay. Genetic testing, how important is that?
Become incredibly important in today's world. You may remember 15 years ago, we sequenced the human genome.
That was fascinating.
Fascinating stuff, but it cost us $3 billion in several years to do.
Wow.
But these days, with the technology, we're now able to generate genetic data on you and on your cancer, determine your risk of disease, and determine if you have a genetic disease, and even determine what therapies may or may not work in you. So really important information we can get now from genetic testing.
So how do we determine if we need a genetic test? I'm assuming family history is huge.
Family history is a huge driver, such as in the Angelina Jolie case.
Perfect example.
Right? Strong family history of breast cancer. In that case, she had BRCA genes tested, which determine whether you have a very high risk of breast cancer in your lifetime. And with that information, she and others can really prevent breast cancer from occurring. So that's one area, is prevention of disease. The other would be you have symptoms, you have a problem, and maybe you have a genetic disease, and therefore testing would be indicated to figure it out. And then finally, like we talked about, the use of genetic testing to determine what therapies may or may not work in you is another, you know, really important area.
And when it comes to Quest Diagnostics, what genetic testings do you have available?
Well, we offer thousands of tests, but increasingly a lot of those are genetic tests.
Mm-hmm.
We do testing for prenatal testing in women.
I did that.
Okay, the genetic testing in women to determine prenatal risk. We do cancer-based testing to determine what therapies will work in a cancer patient. We also do genetic testing to determine risk of breast cancer and other cancers in the future. And then finally, that genetic testing we talked about around diagnosing a disease or even a rare disease to determine what really is going on in this patient.
And I was thinking of rare disease now because we have a series called Behind the Mystery, and we're very proud of it. And we spotlight a lot of rare diseases out there that people are unaware of. Assuming with this kind of testing, it could really help so many people that are misdiagnosed and have no answers.
This is such an important area, really important. We call it the Diagnostic Odyssey. You have patients, and one of them that I've seen was a girl who went for 10 years to 9 or 10 different medical centers.
Misdiagnosed all the
time. No diagnosis, but major health problems, and her family spent $1 million trying to get to the bottom of it.
Oh my gosh.
And then it turns out she ended up getting a genetic test 10 years later.
And she finds out.
She found out that she has a genetic disease. The question was resolved, and there was a treatment for her problem in that case.
So much time, so much money, and
time, money, frustration, uncertainty. So in that case, it's really valuable to get genetic testing.
Speaking of money, genetic testing is becoming more affordable today also?
Absolutely. It's not $3 billion anymore, that's for sure.
It's a big difference.
Right. So over the last 15 years, the technology has improved greatly. So it's much more affordable than it was previously, and now we're able to offer genetics to the community and in an affordable way.
And how is genetic testing done? Let's say somebody says, I'm going to do it.
Well, usually what would happen is your physician would talk with you about the genetic testing, and often a genetic counselor would get involved to help you and the doctor determine what testing is needed and what you're going to do with the information. But then once you've determined that, it's as simple as a blood test or a saliva sample, which you then send into the laboratory. And we do the genetic testing, the results come back, and the doctor and genetic counselor help you understand, you know, what to do with the information.
And ultimately maybe save your life and maybe even your children's in the future.
Hopefully so.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. Great stuff.
Thank you so much,
Olga. Appreciate your time. You're coming back next time to talk about personalized medicine.
I'll be back.
Excellent. Thank you, doctor.
Thanks.
And if you'd like to learn more about this and genetic testing, you can go to the website. It's very easy. Questdiagnostics.com/patients. Again, do that /patients and it'll get you right there. Or just go to our website, thebalancingact.com.